Circular polarization. Circular polarization is a very special case of elliptical polarization. In this special case, the amplitude of the Ex component and Ey component must be equal, and the phase shift between the two components should be pi over 2 or minus pi over 2. So, if these two conditions are satisfied, the polarization of the wave would be circular polarization. And in this case, the arrow of the electric field in the space will rotate as a circle. And according to the side of the angle phi, if the phi is positive pi over 2, the orientation of the rotation would be as a left hand circular polarization or as clockwise. So in this case, according to the propagation, it would be with the left hand or as a clockwise. If the angle phi is negative pi over 2, it would be counterclockwise, as in this arrow, and it would be right-hand circular polarization. Means here, right-hand circular polarization, and if the eye of the observer in the same direction of the propagation, and he is rounding by using the right hand, such that the thumb in the direction of Z, so this would be the direction of the rotation of the electric field. So, circular polarization is a special case of elliptical polarization where Ex equal Ey equal E naught, and the phase shift between Ex and Ey is either plus or minus pi over 2. The instantaneous form of circular polarization can be obtained by taking the real part of the phasor component in this case, so it would be E naught cosine omega t minus beta z in Ax direction, the x component, plus E naught cosine omega t minus beta z plus phi, where phi is plus or minus pi over 2 in y direction. Effectively, cosine x plus pi over 2 is minus sine x, and cosine x minus pi over 2 is plus sine x. So cosine omega t minus beta z plus or minus pi over 2, it can be replaced by minus or plus sine omega t minus beta z in y direction. So the wave function of the x component is cosine function, while the wave function of the y component is sine function. Meaning that when this would be a peak, this would be null. And when this would be null, this would be peak, and vice versa. So in this case, when it is completely x, Ey is 0. When it would be completely Ey, Ex would be 0. So it would be as if rotating from x to y, from y to x, from x to y, and so on. And the amplitude here is constant, which equal E naught. As I mentioned, if the phase shift is positive pi over 2, so the instantaneous electric field at z equals 0 as a function of t would be E naught cosine omega t Ax minus sine omega t Ay. Okay? So at t equals 0, it is completely Ex. When omega t equal pi over 2, 2D minus EY. When omega t would equal pi would be EX equal minus E naught. And when omega t equal 3 pi over 2 would be positive EY. So in this case, he's going to be rotating clockwise. If you are the observer and you are looking along the Z direction and you are using your left hand such that your thumb would be in Z direction, so your four fingers will rotate in this way. So this is left hand circumpolarization. Now, phi equal minus pi over 2, so the instantaneous electric field at Z equals 0 would be E naught cosine omega t plus sine omega t a1, cosine omega t ax plus sine omega t a1. So at t equals 0, the electric field would be in x direction. At omega t equal pi over 2, the x component would be 0 and the y component would be unity. So it would be E naught in y direction. So it is coming from E naught along x to E naught along y. Then when omega t equals pi, it would be cosine omega t would be minus 1 and sine would be 0. So it would be minus E naught in ax in x direction. And finally, when omega t equals 3 pi over 2, it would be minus E naught in y direction. So it is going to be rotating in counterclockwise or anticlockwise. And once again, if you are the observer and your eyes is looking towards Z direction, and now by using your right hand and make the thumb of your right hand in the direction of the Z direction and rotate your four fingers, you will look to be rotating counterclockwise. So this is called right hand circular polarization. Okay. If we are looking in the phasor form, we can say that the circular polarization, as you mentioned, EX naught equal EY naught equal E naught, and the phase shift is Y equal plus or minus Y over 2. So, it can be represented as this phase shift as E to plus or minus e to the power plus or minus j over pi over 2. So this is the phase shift of the y component. So instead of saying sine, we say that this cosine omega t minus beta z multiplied by phase shift equal e to the power plus or minus j pi over 2. So effectively, the phasor component of the circular polarization can be represented as E phasor equal E naught plus multiplied by AX, the X direction, plus or minus J, which represent E to the power plus or minus J by over 2, E to the power J by over 2, can be replaced by plus or minus j. How comes? Effectively, e to the power jx is cosine x plus j sine x. And effectively, cosine pi over 2 is 0. So, e to the power plus j pi over 2 is j sine pi over 2, which is plus j. And e to the power minus j pi over 2 is j sine minus pi over 2, which is minus j. So the phase shift here can be represented as plus or minus j y direction. multiplied by the propagation constant in the direction e to the power minus j beta 0. Here, the plus sign correspond to phi equal pi over 2, positive pi over 2, which correspond to the left hand circle polarization, and the negative sign correspond to phi equal minus pi over 2, which correspond to the right hand circle polarization or counterclockwise. What will be the situation if this wave is propagating in negative z direction instead of positive z direction? So if it is propagating in negative z direction, the propagation constant e to the power minus j beta z would be e to the power positive j beta z. Now, if the phase shift is pi over 2, or the phase shift or the y component is j, so in this case, it would be right-hand circle polarization, because the direction of the propagation is inverted. So in this case, it would be right-hand circle polarization if the phase is positive y over 2. If the phase is negative y over 2, it would be left-hand circle polarization. Effectively, it is the opposite as if the propagation in positive z direction. Right? So if the propagation is inverted from positive to negative, effectively the signs here would correspond to left and right would be also inverted. Here we can see an example of linear polarization and circular polarization. Here we have linear polarization. Say this is the x direction, so this is x propagating wave and this y propagating wave. So this linear polarized in x direction, this is linear polarized in y direction. Now by combining the linear polarized x direction with y direction, we can obtain right hand circular polarization. Here, if you are using your right hand, you will find that you are tracing the direction of the rotation of the electric field point. The other phase between the y component and the x component, we are using our left hand. So this left hand circular polarization. So this is an emission for linear polarization and the two types of circular polarization, right hand and left hand circular polarization. The question now, what will be the result if we are making superposition of two circular polarization? So assuming that, what is the result of superimposing left and right circular polarized fields of the same amplitude? So we have the same amplitude, the same frequency, and propagation in the same direction, but with a phase shift delta in radians between the two circular polarizations. So first of all, let us represent these two circular polarization in their phase of form. So the phase of form of the total field would equal the phase of form of the right hand circular polarization plus the phase of form of the left hand circular polarization. The phase of form of the right hand circular polarization would be E naught multiplied by AX minus JAY, this shift minus pi over 2, multiplied by e to the power minus jz. The left hand circle polarization has the same amplitude, so e naught is the same, and the same frequency, same propagation direction, so it would be e to the power minus j beta z, so it would be the same, but with phase shift delta in radian. So we have phase shift e to the power j, tilde. Okay? So in this case, the left hand circle polarized component would be E naught AX plus J plus J to introduce the left hand circle polarization AY multiplied by E to the power minus J beta Z. E naught is the same. This was right hand circle polarization. That's why it is minus J. Now it is plus J because it is left hand circle polarization. E to the power minus j beta z, e to the power minus j beta z, the same propagation constant and the same frequency. And the phase shift, e to the power j delta. Okay? So, this is the total phasor component of the superposition of this right hand and left hand circular polarized fields. Now, let us add the x component together and the y component together. So the total x component, it would be E naught multiplied by 1 plus E to the power j delta in x direction. And the y component, let us take minus j as a common. So minus j 1. Here it is plus j, so minus minus to be plus, so minus e to the power j delta in y direction. And all of them is propagating in z direction, e to the power minus j beta z. Okay? Alright. We can simplify 1 plus e to the power j delta as e to the power j delta over 2 multiplied by e to the power minus j delta over 2 plus e to the power j delta over 2. I have taken e to the power j delta over 2 as a common factor. And similarly, in this bracket, would be e to the power minus j delta over 2 minus e to the power j delta over 2. Okay? Effectively, e to the power minus jx plus e to the power jx equals 2 cosine the value. So this can be replaced by 2 multiplied by cosine delta over 2 in x direction. And minus j multiplied by e to the power minus jx minus e to the power jx is equivalent to 2 sine the value. So this can be replaced. All this stuff can be replaced by 2 sine delta over 2. So the total field in this case would be 2 multiplied by E naught multiplied by cosine delta over 2 in x direction plus sine delta over 2 in y direction multiplied by the propagation constant e to the power minus j beta z multiplied by another phase shift e to the power minus minus or plus j delta over 2. Okay? Effectively, this is the propagation constant, this is the phase shift, and this is the amplitude. Let us look at the amplitude. In this case, the x component is multiplied by a real factor cosine delta over 2, and the y component is multiplied by a real factor sine delta over 2. So both the x component and y component in this case are in phase. So we return back to linear polarization. Linear polarization is composed of x component and y component, and the phase shift between them is 0. So here the phase shift between them is 0. So this is linear polarized wave, and it is tilted wave. It is not completely X, it is not completely Y. So, the angle of tilting is delta over 2 because we have sine delta over 2 in Y direction and cosine delta over 2 in X direction. So, the slope of the electric field would be tan delta over 2. So, in this case, the total field due to the superposition of two equal circular polarized components would be a linear polarized component, and if there is a phase shift delta between the two circular polaris component, the resulting linear polaris component will be tilted with respect to x-axis by an angle delta over 2. So we say that which is the electric field of linear polarized wave whose field vector is oriented at an angle delta over 2 from x-axis. So assuming that there is no phase shift, or means that delta equals 0, so the resulting field in this case would be completely electric field in x direction. And if the phase shift was pi over 2, so the resulting field in this case would be completely linear polarized in y direction. Pi. If the delta is pi, so it would be pi over 2 here, it would be in y direction. Okay? So, from this example, we can conclude that if we have two opposite circular polarization of equal amplitude and we add both of them, the resulting field would be a linear polarization. Effectively, this is very important property of circular polarization, because in some materials, the right-hand circular polarization have a propagation constant and the left-hand circular polarization has another propagation constant. So, if we have an incident plane wave on such a material and we are interested to find out how the wave will be propagating inside this material, we can decompose the linear polarized waves into two circular polarization with opposite direction, one in the right hand and the other in the left hand. Then we are studying the right hand with the propagation constant of the right hand and study the left hand with the propagation constant of the left hand. And at the end, or at the other end of the material, we are going to sum the two components once again to obtain the total electric field going out of such material. That's what we are seeing. Circular polarization to other polarizations. We can conclude that any linear polarized wave can be expressed as a sum of two circular polarized waves of the same amplitude and opposite handness. So, any linear polarized can be assumed as summation of right-hand circular polarized wave plus left-hand circular polarized wave of the same amplitude, where the linear polarization direction is determined by the relative phase difference between the two circular polarized waves. So, if this linear polarized wave is tilted with a certain angle, so we can obtain this angle by the relative phase between the right hand and left hand circular polarized component of this linear polarized wave. On the other hand, any elliptical polarized wave can be expressed as the sum of two circular polarized waves of unequal amplitude. Take care. In the linear polarized wave, it is composed of two circular polarized waves of the same amplitude. Here in elliptical polarized, any elliptical polarized wave can be expressed as the sum of two circular polarized waves of unequal amplitude and opposite handness. So also we have one right hand and one left hand, but with different amplitudes, where the direction of the major axis of the elliptical wave is determined by the relative phase difference between the two waves. Once again, as in the linear polarized wave, the direction of the linear polarized is determined by the phase shift between the left hand and right hand circular polarization. Here in elliptical polarization, the direction of the major axis is determined by the relative phase difference between the right hand and left hand circular polarization. And the direction of rotation of this elliptical polarized wave is the direction of rotation of the circular polarization with the greater amplitude. So, in the case of elliptical polarization, it is decomposed into two circular polarization, one right hand and the other is left hand. Assuming that the amplitude of the right hand is greater than the left hand, So this elliptical polarization is right hand. On the other hand, if the amplitude of the left hand is greater than the right hand, so this elliptical polarization is left hand. The amplitude of the major axis is the summation of the amplitude of the two circular polarization. So in this case, the major axis, its amplitude is the summation of the amplitude of the right hand plus the left hand, while the minor axis is the difference. So in this case, the minor axis would be the amplitude of the right hand, assuming it is the greater, minus the amplitude of the left hand, assuming it's the smaller. So effectively, as a special case for the linear polarization, it is one direction, which corresponds to the major axis. So the minor axis is zero. That's why in linear polarization, it was two circular polarizations of the same amplitude. So the total field would have the magnitude of the summation of two circular polarizations in one direction of this linear polarized contour. So in general, we can represent a linear polarization as summation of two circular polarized fields of different orientations or different hardness. Similarly, we can represent elliptical polarization as summation of two circular polarizations of different hardness. So we can assume that circular polarization is a general case, and we can derive linear polarization and elliptical polarization from circular polarization. In the previous video, we have shown that elliptical polarization can be assumed as the general case, and we can derive linear polarization and circular polarization as special forms of elliptical polarization. So effectively, the three types of polarization, linear polarization, elliptical polarization, and circular polarization, are completely interlaced with each other. So we can obtain any polarization from the other type of the polarization. So in general speaking, we can determine the any type of polarization based on any other type of polarization. So we can obtain linear polarization from elliptical polarization, we can obtain linear polarization from circular polarization. On the other hand, from elliptical polarization, we can obtain circular polarization as a special case, we can obtain linear polarization as a special case. Finally, from circular polarization, we can decompose linear polarization as a summation of two different hardness circular polarization with equal amplitude, and also we can decompose elliptical polarization as summation of different hardness of circular polarization with unequal amplitudes. Okay, all right, now we have completed chapter 10, sorry, we have completed chapter 11. Starting from the next video, we are going to chapter 12 regarding to the reflection and transmission of electromagnetic wave if you are going from one media to another media. Okay? Alright.